Third one, it is going to be a high one triangle, and these are given 10 degrees, and here is given 20 degrees, and then this angle alpha is asked. Okay. First step, notice that this triangle is an isosceles triangle, right? Because base angles are equal. So these two lengths must be equal to each other. After that, in these type of specific questions, we need to catch equilateral or isosceles triangles. Therefore, when we come across angles of 10 and 20 degrees, we usually should look for an equilateral triangle. So we know that to create an equilateral triangle, we need to reach 60 degrees, right? Why? Because all angles of an equilateral triangle are 60 degrees. If you notice that some of these angles equal 10 plus 10 plus 20, so 40 degrees. Therefore, if you find one more 20 degrees, we can reach 60 degrees, right? So if we create an isosceles triangle with base angles of 20 degrees, we can reach 60 degrees, right? Therefore, this angle has now become 60 degrees, right? Next step, if we connect these two corners, we get an equilateral triangle. We know that every isosceles triangle with a vertex angle of 60 degrees is an equilateral triangle. So 50 degrees left here. And this blue line must be equal to ours. Therefore, at the beginning of the problem, we have found the equilateral triangle we are looking for. Okay, so now if you focus on this triangle, we know that in a triangle, sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees, so 50 degrees left here, right? Notice that we get two same angles. That means this triangle is also an isosceles triangle. So this length must be equal to others. If you notice, as a result, we ended up with an isosceles triangle in this case. So if vertex equal 20 degrees, that means base angles must be equal 80 degrees. Therefore, 50 plus alpha equal 80 degrees, so alpha is going to be 30 degrees, right? Or you can think like this. Let's clear here. Notice that, let's call here point O. We have three same length, right? So that means point O is the circumcircle of this triangle, right? That means point O is center of circumcircle of this triangle. So if here is alpha, that means center angle must be equal to alpha, right? So 2 alpha equals 60 degrees. That means alpha is going to be 30 degrees. But now we will calculate the value of alpha using trigonometric form of Sivar's theorem. First of all, let's call here theta. We know that in a triangle, sum of the interior angles equals 180 degrees, right? So 10 plus 10 plus 10 plus 20 equal 180 degrees. That means alpha plus theta equal 130 degrees. So theta equal 130 minus alpha, right? is right here, 130 minus alpha. Now we can apply GeoMathry. Sine alpha over, we are not taking the second angle, we are taking the next angle. So sine 10 times sine 20 equal, now we multiply the remaining angles. Sine 130 minus alpha times sine 10 times plus 1 sine 10. So if you simplify the expression, these are again sine alpha over sine 130 minus alpha equal sine 10 over sine 20. Right? We know that the expansion of sine 20 equal 2 times sine 10 times cosine 10. Therefore, these are again. So we know that there is a 1 here, right? So it can be written as sine 30 instead of 1 over 2. Right? And we know that cosine 10 equals sine 80. And then, likewise, sines of the supplementary angles are equal. That means we can calculate sine 50 plus alpha instead of sine 130 minus alpha. Right? Now, you can see easily alpha is going to be 30 degrees. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye bye.